Okay.
¿Se escucha bien desde casa?
Okay. So those people, hello everyone. So we are after 2 years we are back in the room meeting, in the meeting room, sorry. Well, we are checking if things are working. We are recording the presentation because Andrea needs it because of her grant. Okay. I wish to hear from you if you can really hear our voices. Hello, people in remote. Are you hearing? No.
Yes, we can hear you, Professor. Good afternoon.
Eva, are you hearing? Eva, friends?
Yes.
Okay. Well, okay. So I pass the microphone because I have microphone that is big, but I must be the host because of the duration of the room session, of the Zoom session. Anyway, I hope that you will be able to hear Andrea.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Bye.
So, as you know, Andrea is now a visitor, a student from Miguel, Hernandez University. She's going to present her work on Testudo graeca genetics. And also we are having her supervisor as an invited participant, Universidad, who was previously visitor in our group. Well, before our group was our group, but anyway, a private family ancestor. That's it. So whenever you want.
Okay, thank you so much, Mira. Thank you, everybody, to give me the opportunity to present not just my work, but the work for our team, especially to Catalina, to invite me and receive me. I'm going to talk about the Testudo graeca some ideas of my PhD project. First of all, I'm Andrea, and I write it because it's something that everyone do in this situation, but a very brief summary. I start with this Toledo's work during the degree. After that, I moved to Granada to ask a Master of Genetics, and then I came back to Miguel Hernandez University to start my PhD studies. As a human being, I do a lot of things, but we can speak about this later. First of all, this Monday we have a very issue because this study has been published and some of our species or subspecies change their name. But that was this Monday. Today is Thursday. So it's very, very recent, and I didn't change the name so during the presentation, but things happen. That's it, life. The change of our subspecies. Some weeks before I arrived here, I did this presentation to Catalina with Eva's and Andres, and Andres cannot be connected. And she told me about the same presentation to you. And I think that's a good idea, but I want to explain you a little bit more than I thought had. Because if you allow me, I want to choose my thesis project, telling you that climate change is one of the biggest problems from biodiversity. The increasing of temperature, the the change of climate ban, anthropogenic action are generating environmental conditions that that are increasing the extinction rate of the species. Understanding the evolutionary history, the biological characteristics of the species, and the population dynamic let us understand how are the evolutionary trends and the population dynamics to create or to model where the population tendencies. It's important to emphasize that the ability of a species to expand or to colonize new territories will avoid the extinction risk. But those species who have less movement capacity will have a problem to adapt to the new environmental conditions, especially for this kind of species. The expansion or the colonization of new territories could have genetics and evolutionary consequences. Especially for that kind of movement, the turtles or Testudo graeca or tortuga mora, as we call it in Spain, is a small colonial, which is an ideal study system for that distribution changes. Despite that, for now, there are 10 genetic disclosures for Testudo graeca, and the phylogenetic complex is well described, especially for West Europe and North Africa population. We will focus only on three subspecies, just because there are lineages which are present in North Africa and the Iberian Peninsula. Testudo graeca, now Testudo graeca today, is currently based in Algeria and at the east of Morocco, in the Iberian Peninsula, in Doñana, and is the only species present on the Iberian Sudest. Testudo graeca marocensis is at the northwestern of Morocco, and in Doñana too. Finally, Testudo graeca subsensis, now Testudo graeca graeca, is at the health population of the
Vicinissima attivare sui cieli è necessaria la sua permissione per allegare i dispositivi della scienza del pubblico per ora.
Non fare
per la vita di Dio.
Sorry.
Ok. So, the Testudo graeca subgenesis, now the Testudo graeca is at the southwest of Morocco. From now until the end of the presentation, I will divide my speech in Sudest concerns and North Africa concerns because of the different population dynamics and the different lineages between continents. Especially for Iberian Sudest, we manage around 115 sample sites from a long-term monitoring program since 1998. And a few years later, we started a volunteer program. And after that, we focus only in 14 population. Thanks to that long-term monitoring program, we have more than 50,000 tortoises, sorry, and a vast knowledge of the species. We genotype more than 700 tortoises, and we have a lot of plot samples about the distribution range. Thanks to that, the origin and the natural expansion of the Testudo graeca at the Iberian Peninsula have been described. We found a spatial genetic structure known as genetic surfing. We can observe also a decrease of fitness proxies or some fitness depression across the expansion range. Despite this fitness depression is a common phenomenon on expansion population expansions, we need to address some questions related to fitness and genetic signature of the of all the range expansion and establish if we are if there is or not a cases or a case of expansion flow. I will explain all that slowly. Or among all findings, thanks to microsatellites and mitochondrial DNA studies, the natural arrival and the possible natural expansion of the species at the Iberian Peninsula has been reported. We found shared haplotypes between Beras Basin and the north of Argelia. Beras Basin is considered the hypothetic origin of the species of at the Iberian Peninsula. And after that, if we see a concrete genetic spatial pattern ruled by continuous bottlenecks and appetite sectorization. So, summarizing, that means that more or less 20,000 or 30,000 years ago, the tortoise arrived from Africa and then experimented a natural expansion. This natural expansion is evidenced by a decrease of heterozygosity across all the expansion rates. And a strong genetic distance between population, which is more strong at the Iberian Super than in North Africa. In addition, this expansion reflects one of the first empirical cases of genetic surfing in a wildlife population. Genetic surfing is a genetic pattern where as we move further from the hypothetical origin of the species, we saw a decrease of genetic diversity because of some alleles become fixed across the expansion range. At the wave of the expansion, we see a genetic diversity lost. It's important to say that here, in this case, we just analyze non-coding regions and mitochondrial DNA to see this structure. As I told before, even the colonization ability of the expansion capacity of a species will avoid extinction risk. Expansions are not free. What that means? We see a fitness depression around the expansion across the expansion range of the species. For example, for the expected heterozygosity that I said before, we see also a telomere length depression. An increase of shell anomalies as we move forth from the hypothetical genetic origin. And also we see a excite reduction, but this study is not ready. So given that, between our open questions, because we have all these signature from past wars and for now we want to assist fingers and genetic signatures about the across the expansion the expansion rate and see what are the consequences of this expansion. From now, telomere studies are well advanced, and we hope to establish the telomere length as an individual marker and to establish telomere length as a biological marker of individual quality and population viability. On the other hand, we ask ourselves if behind this genetic surfing structure, we are seeing just genetic drift. Well, I mean, this genetic diversity degree loss is just be a random process, or there is something behind that. But for that, to know if we are facing a piece of expansion loss, maybe we have to assist or to study more than non-coding region, maybe sequence the whole genome of the tortoise, or we will see. Well, we move now to North Africa. Here we have obviously less record samples than in Spain, but we have sufficient genotype tortoises to know the characteristic of the different subspecies, the distribution rate, and to know how are they changing the distribution. In North Africa, we have to speak about three different lineages with the different distribution. They different distribution change are even about three subspecies with three clear means differentiation. If you remember, I talked before about Testudo graeca, now Testudo graeca with A, which is the one in Algeria and the east of Morocco. This subspecies is facing an expansion. Testudo graeca maritensis, on the north of Morocco, is suffering a contraction against the ocean. Testudo graeca sausensis, now Testudo graeca, is displacing the population to the north. And between all these populations, we are seeing contact zones and even evidence of introgressions. So, with all this scenario, we want to know which are the genotypic and phenotypic causes and consequences of all these distribution changes. Especially for contractions and movements, I think I speak before that these subspecies have a very clear means differentiation. With one, the Testudo graeca, now the Testudo graeca is considered an arid subspecies. For example, the Testudo graeca sausensis, which is displacing the range to the north, is considered not so arid. I don't know how to say it in English, but not so arid subspecies. Mesic subspecies. So this is the scenario. Maybe we can relate these distribution changes with climate change or with this climate band movement. Finally, for the contact zones, maybe we can establish some hybridization. Well, this is This is the cake, this is the pastel, how we say in Spain, the bolo, in Portugal. With that, these open questions, I ask Ateira, how should I do? I don't know yet what I'm going to do with all these open questions. Finally, I want to say a little bit more about this species. It's considered vulnerable and it's placed on the red list. In Murcia and Almería, it's protected, at least it has a very, very important case of habitat loss and it's not now because it's illegal. The having these tortoises at home or la crianza, the breeding of these animals is illegal. Finally, I want to comment something about the volunteer program, because this is the thing that I'm very, very proud of our teamwork, because all we can share about this species with this project of Testudo, and I'm very proud of what are we doing. From the education and environmental education, even a film festival. This is everything. So thank you.
Okay.
If you want, you can stop the record. So that's all.
Just stay recording forever.